In previous videos, we introduced the concepts of devices, objects, properties, and services. Now we want to explain how these concepts provide functional capabilities referred to as interoperability areas. The five interoperability areas are data sharing, alarm and event management, scheduling, trending, and device and network management. The first area is data sharing, which is the exchange of data between BACnet devices for the purpose of data collection, monitoring, and control. In data sharing, a client device makes a request of a server device in regard to a particular server property. In a read property request, the server will provide the value of the property indicated. In a write property request, a value is sent that changes the indicated property. Up to 16 levels of priority exist when writing values, thereby allowing for one client to take precedence over another. If two clients are writing to the same server using the same priority level, the last value sent will be stored. To minimize data traffic, change of value, COV, is supported where only values that change above a defined limit are sent. This minimizes network traffic. A client subscribes to the server device, and the server monitors the property and reports when the subscribed property exceeds the threshold range. The next area is alarm and event management, which defines the exchange of data based on predefined alarm limits or event triggers. An alarm or event notification process is as follows. An object detects that an alarm has occurred. Using a notification class object, the object determines when and where the alarm is reported. An event notification message is sent to one or more alarm recipients. Notifications await acknowledgement by the recipient if they are confirmed notifications. There are two types of alarm reporting methods. Intrinsic reporting means that the detecting object has built-in alarm detection logic. Algorithmic reporting means that the event enrollment object is used to do the detection through constant monitoring. The third area is scheduling, where equipment is controlled based upon time and dates residing within BACnet devices. Calendar objects are used to indicate whether each day is active or inactive according to that calendar. Schedule objects are based upon time value pairs that specify a value to use at a particular time. Schedules can have exceptions to accommodate holidays. Internal and external scheduling are supported. A client device can act on its own schedule or direct the activities of server devices without schedules, called external scheduling. A server device can act on its own schedule, called internal scheduling, or have its schedule overwritten by a client. The fourth area is trending, where data is sampled over time and stored for future review. Trending allows BACnet devices to enable trend collection and request trend data from other BACnet devices. One possibility is to simply use read property, or COV, to periodically sample data in devices from a centralized client location, but this could prove inefficient. Another possibility is to use the trend log object that manages the sampling of data while storing the results. A supervisory client could then gather the trend log data in bulk through polling or through event notification. Internal and external trending are supported. A client device can trend objects within its own device along with objects in other devices. This is called external trending. A server device may not be able to trend at all, or may only be able to trend its own objects. This is called internal trending. The final area is device and network management. Device and network management allows BACnet devices to discover other BACnet devices, discover objects within devices, establish and reestablish communications, synchronize time, or reinitialize a device's program. Device binding is the process of establishing connections between devices by uniquely identifying devices using device instance, network number, and MAC address. Static device binding requires human intervention. Dynamic device binding is an automatic discovery process using WHOIS and IAM services. Learn more about BACnet by watching other videos in our Understanding BACnet series. Thanks for watching.